Hello and welcome back all of you my dear students to our new video. Now in the previous videos we have learned a lot regarding the agriculture. Now in the previous videos I told you what is agriculture. Basically and we have seen that in this agriculture there are different types of allied activities. I told you about sericulture, then pisciculture, apiculture, animal husbandry, bee farming and all these things we have studied in our last video. Now today we will be learning about what are the types of agriculture. So there are basically two types, that is what we will be learning today, and what are the subtypes of that farming and agriculture, that is what we will be learning. So right now we are learning the types of farming. So basically there are two perspectives of looking at this thing that we call as farming. One type is the type that we use to do, like farming is what? Cultivation of certain crops or plants to gain the food material. So one aspect of this farming is for survival of ourselves, because you see we require food for us daily, right? You see there are only few days that we do fast. On those particular days we will not eat anything, but rest of the days we don't kind of neglect the food. Okay, we eat all this food on a regular basis daily. So survival is most important thing, and farming will give us the food or the plant to get the food so that we could survive. Then the next thing, we can do it also for business or for earning money. Simply we can use to make food. Okay, we will grow this food, we will do farming, and we will sell this food material to the people who are not doing anything in the farming industry. Okay, if farming activities. So business is what we can also do of this farming. So the name of, like, the official name that we have given to both of these things, that is, first is called as the type of farming that we do for survival, it is called as subsistence farming. Subsistence farming. And the type of farming that we do for pure business or for earning money, that is called as commercial farming. Subsistence farming and commercial farming. Now in both of them, the main aim of this farming is different. This is for survival and this is for earning money. So there are certain things that we will do here which we will not do here, and there are certain things that we will do over here which are not seen in this commercial farming. So what are all these things we will see? First of all, subsistence farming is categorized as two different kind of processes. Now one is shifting cultivation, and okay, shifting cultivation, and another one is intensive farming. Now the meaning of both of them, first of all let's look at what is intensive farming. Intensive farming is nothing but that we have a limited space or an area of land and we try to grow maximum output in this available land. That is what we are trying to grow, more agricultural produce in limited availability of the land. That is what it is called as intensive farming. So we will try to use every space on this particular land to grow certain food. It might be two types of food, three types of food, or anything else. Okay, grains, then cereals, pulses, or vegetables, or fruit, whatever it may be. So availability of land is less and production is more. Okay, we are trying to produce more in small space. That is what it is called as intensive farming. So in this farming, what we will do is that we will plant these crops very close to each other. So this is what intensive farming. Now what is shifting farming? When we try to do intensive farming over a few years, okay, so let's say we are kind of at one place okay, we have land over and we are growing intensive, like we are doing the intensive farming in this land for a few years. Let's say 3 to 4 years we will be doing intensive farming. Now what happens is that the fertility of soils gets reduced due to this farming activities, and in order to regain this particular fertility of the soil, it requires certain amount of time. So what we do is that as the fertility of this land has decreased, we will move to another piece of land. Okay, we will go to another piece of land and we will try to do the farming once again in this place, and we will leave this place and we will go to another place. That is the basic meaning of shifting cultivation of or shifting of these farms. So what is it? It is to regain the fertility of this land that we were using previously to grow the crops. So that is what it is done for subsistence. Now today we don't see this type of thing happening because you see we have demarcated the borders of the states and the countries. So in the previous years when man was kind of in the developmental phase, the stone age and all these ages, this thing was very much done in that ages. But today it is not done because you see land is being kind of allotted to people, okay, and there is the 7/12 extract, ownership of land, the government has the ownership of the land, and certain private people also have the ownership. So that is why today these things are not done, okay. Shifting and intensive farming is done by the people who own the land, but shifting is not seen today. Yes, we can purchase another land and we could do this thing, we could shift our farm, we could sell our farm and we could do farming on another people's farm by buying it. But in the previous years, okay, previous ages, about a few thousand years ago, this shifting was done in free, okay. There were no regulations, no governmental body is looking at these things, okay, in the stone age. But after the urban civilization started, you see the Harappan civilization, then the Mesopotamia and all these things. When this civilization started, the regulation on land started to increase. So that is why shifting nowadays is not seen as much as intensive farming and farming for subsistence. Now you have to understand, these people are growing food for only themselves. Okay, these farmers, those who grow the agricultural output for themselves so that they could survive an entire year. And if the output is more than they require, then they will sell it. Okay, they have the option to sell it. But mostly it is done only for our own survival. So, due to this not selling of the crops and the output, these farmers stay poor. Okay, these farmers will grow for themselves in a limited amount. Okay, the capacity, as I told you, they have less land and they will try to get more output. And due to that thing, due to availability of less land, they have less output, and due to that less output, they are not able to sell this in another markets, and due to that money, the inflow of money is not there towards their home. So that is why most of the farmers who are doing subsistence farming for survival of themselves, they are poor. Now in the opposite scenario, in the commercial farming, okay, the farmers are relatively rich than these people who are doing it for subsistence. So we will now talk about the commercial farming and the types of that thing. So as I told you that commercial farming is done purely for business and for earning money. There are certain types in this commercial farming. That is what? First is extensive grain farming. Then there is plantation farming. Then there is market farming or market gardening. Okay, market gardening. And there is another one that is called as हॉर्टिकल्चर एंड फ्लोरिकल्चर. नाउ इन ऑल ऑफ दिस थिंग्स व्हाट हैपन्स इज दैट यू सी हियर इन द एक्सटेंसिव ग्रेन फार्मिंग द फार्म्स विल बी इन अ वेरी प्लेन एरिया. ओके, प्लेन एरिया विल बी देयर, प्लेटो विल बी देयर, एंड ऑन दिस फार्म we will try to grow one type of crops. Okay, one type of crop only will be grown in this place. So that what will happen? It will give us more money for that crop. Okay, cash crops are what we call something like. So in extensive farming, the land is plain. It is mostly more than 200 hectares. Okay, 200 plus hectares. And only one type of crop is grown, that is called as monocrop. Okay, monocrop is grown. So you might see that in very flat plains there are big farms of wheat, rice and maize, sugarcane, all these different things. So what is it? That is called as extensive grain farming or extensive crop farming. So one type of crop is grown. Now due to this what will happen? We will kind of produce them in large quantities, and due to production in large quantity we can earn more money. Now we can also grow certain food material that is having high price. Okay, cash crops is what? Some crops are there which have high price than the another crop. So that is what it is done in the extensive grain farming. Now here we will use less manpower, but we will use more technology like tractors, then irrigation methods and all these things. Again, fertilizers, pesticides and all these things we will use over here, because the farm is over a large area and man alone cannot do all these things. Okay, man force will be very less used in this type of farming, because it is very inadequate or insufficient. Manpower alone is insufficient for this type of farming. So that is why extensive grain farming is considered as a commercial farming. Second one is plantation farming or plantation method. Now in this method what happens is that, like you see, as this is done in plain areas, this plantation method is done in the hilly areas. Because you see, in the hilly areas we cannot go over there and we could drive a tractor along the tracks. So in this hilly area labor is required, and if the area is more than 40 hectares, that is what, and we are growing certain plants which are geographically suitable to that area, which will grow over there just by using the climate. These types of crops is what we will grow in these places. Okay, so plantation farming is done in hilly areas with a land of more than 40 plus hectares. Now here we cannot use technology. Here there is no plain, so that plain land, so that we could drive our tractors and all these things. Here man force or man labor work is more required than the extensive grain farming. But still, here we will grow the plants which are in demand in that particular geographic area. So you might have seen in northeastern states and in the states near the Jammu and Kashmir, Ladakh region, over there we don't see crops of wheat and all these things. Okay, rice, we don't see all of them over there. But in northeastern states we see tea is grown a lot. Again in Jammu and Kashmir and all these places, apples, all these things are grown. So why it is happening? It is because the geographical area is very much suitable for such types of plants. So that is why you see it happening over there. Then market gardening, you see, in a particular city there is a demand of particular vegetables or fruits. Now the market gardening is a kind of commercial farming that we do when we are near a city like this. This is a city, let's say, and markets, these gardens will be around the vicinity of this city, and they will be growing the food materials or the fruits or the vegetables that are in more demand in this city. So they will grow them over here and they will send it in the markets near the city. So this is what they will be gardening, such certain plants that are kind of in more demand for eating purpose and for other things also, for medicinal purpose. So Market gardening is what? The type of farming that we do around the vicinity of a city. Then horticulture and floriculture, as I told you, floriculture, horticulture, there is a demand of fruits and flowers. Okay, flowers are mostly used for decoration purpose and for making different kinds of perfumes. And again, we do a lot of devotional works and all these things you might have seen in our culture that we do every day using these flowers. So that is why they are also grown in a certain garden type of place. Like you see, there are certain enclosed spheres where we grow these things. Then horticulture is the same thing like gardening of plants. So that is what it is done for business. Because you see, growing fruit and selling them, and also the flowers, this is a kind of like demand will be different for each thing. Okay, for fruits there will be more demand, for flowers there will, for certain types of flowers there will be more demand. So that is why these things are done in commercial farming. Okay, so these are the two types of farming: commercial farming and subsistence farming. I hope you might have got to know the difference between the survival and the business aspect of this farming. So that's all for today, and we will meet in our next video. Bye.